Welcome, fellas. In front of you are probably two of the most powerful cordless drills on the planet. On the left is the Bosch Professional GSR 18 150C B-turbo with 150 Nm of torque. And on the right is a really good copy of it, the all-new Parkside Performance PPBSA 20A1. Both machines are brushless, with a maximum torque of 150 Nm, 2-speed gearbox, an additional lever for disengaging the clutch, torque selector with 25 predefined settings, a keyless chuck manufactured by Rheom. The Bosch is made in Malaysia, the Parkside is made in China. Both machines feature a Bluetooth connectivity. In order to utilize that connectivity, on the Parkside you need a smart battery, simply because the Bluetooth module is integrated in the smart battery. On the Bosch, you need to purchase an additional Bluetooth module with the size of a coin, which in Bulgaria is almost impossible to find. All major power tool retailers don't keep a stock of that module. And if you order it, you have to wait for them to order it from Bosch. One really annoying exercise. That's why I don't have such module, but this won't interfere with my tests. Before going deeper, I will make a short criticism to Bosch and of course to Parkside, but Parkside is copying Bosch, so the problem comes from Bosch. Fellow engineers from Bosch, what the hell is this? I'm pretty sure that with a potato masher and two zip ties, I could come up with a better design of this handlebar, and most importantly, a stronger one. I know that you're trying to minimize the manufacturing expenses, but this is simply ridiculous. This is the Parkside handlebar, which is almost identical with the Bosch, and only after the first test with the machine, I've managed to strip the teeth over here, holding the handlebar to the body, and I'm pretty sure that I will be able to do so with the handlebar of the Bosch. Let's compare the two power tools. The Parkside is slightly longer, I think about 1 cm. The height of the machines is identical. Like I already said, the handlebars are absolutely the same. Interesting detail is that Bosch is shipping its machine with a depth stop rod, while such rod is not available in the briefcase of Parkside. The weight of the Bosch is 1.8 kilograms, while the Parkside weighs only 1.7. The 8 amps hour pro core battery weighs almost 1 kilo, and the same goes for the Parkside smart battery. The pro core battery, similar to the Milwaukee Red lithium battery, looks way more rigid than the Parkside, and again, similar to the Milwaukee battery, it has metal reinforcement. The gear selectors on both machines feel the same. The same goes for the torque selectors. On the Bosch, the lever disengaging the clutch has one really unpleasant backlash. While on the Parkside, it's rock solid. Something really annoying on the Parkside, when the trigger is gently pressed, the machine starts at certain RPMs and a fraction of a second later, the RPMs go lower. Such thing is not noticeable on the Bosch. And I think that the trigger on the Bosch is a little bit more sensitive. Let's verify the RPMs on both machines. In first gear, they should be 550 RPMs, and in second gear 2200. First gear, Parkside. Second gear. First gear, Bosch. Chicks on the both machines are identical, manufactured by Riom. Interesting is that Parkside is using a left-threaded bolt with a Phillips head, while Bosch is using a left-threaded bolt with a Torx head, which I think is more resilient to stripping the head of the bolt. Both machines feature a kickback control. On the Parkside, you have to access the radio application to switch it off, while on the Bosch you can use the button here. Interesting feature, unfortunately not available on Parkside but only on Bosch and controllable via this button here and the Bosch application, is the electronic angle detection. The machine can be set to drill at a specified angle, and when the user is holding it and the correct angle is reached, this LED here goes green. Those are the internals of the machines. As you know, this is not my first disassembly video, so trust me guys, the disassembly of the Parkside is real pain in the ass. I don't know who's the engineer of this shit, probably some idiot in Germany, but in order to remove the plastics and gain access to the brushless motor, you need to firstly remove the chuck, the torque regulating collet, this aluminium housing over the gearbox, which in our case is also overlapping the plastics and interfering with their removal. You have no idea how much hammering the chuck took in order to remove it, and this is a brand new chuck on a brand new machine. I could only imagine how hard would it be to remove it after, let's say, 1 year of usage. This is absolutely idiotic design. The Bosch is 1000 times easier to disassemble. Enough with the shitty engineering, let's take a look what's inside. The both brushless motors are with a hole sensor. When compared one to another, they look pretty similar. Of course, the control boards are totally different. As for the gearboxes, the design is quite similar. When doing the disassembly, I've noticed that the plastics on the Bosch, and not only on the Bosch, on the Milwaukee also, are stronger and more rigid than the plastics on the Parkside. The two machines are perfectly cold. With fully charged batteries. This is the hardest wood that I managed to find, a massive beech. Let's do the same exercise with Bosch. Just a second, guys. I think it needs rebooting. Well, the temperature is way lower, about 40 degrees lower. The new Parkside Performance is definitely an amazing machine, but the clear winner here is the Bosch 150C. With a price of only 100 euros currently in Germany, there's no other machine with such qualities available on the market today. But the low price brings some drawbacks, like the over temperature protection not calculated properly. You saw how the machine was smoking, the temperature was nearly 95 degrees Celsius, but if I open the lid of application, under 2 over temperature times, we see 0. I don't know what event should trigger this protection, probably fire coming from the motor, but definitely 95 degrees Celsius are okay for the engineers from Grizzly. I think that's enough for this review. You know the drill. If you like it, thumbs up and subscribe. Bye, guys.